Welcome students to the e-learning classes of SJC where learning never stops. In this video, I'm going to teach social study lesson number 2, changing lifestyles. So we are going to learn how lifestyles have changed over time. Lifestyles means the way in which people live or way of living. So students, over a period of time, lifestyles of people around the world have changed. This change have come through inventions, discoveries and advancement of technology, which has made our lives better. Changes can be seen in the way people dress today and the mode of transportation available. Housing and food habits of people have also changed. There has been great progress in the education and entertainment. Let us learn how our present is different from our past. First of all, let us talk about transportation. Transportation has changed the way people live and work today. These days, we use buses, auto rickshaws, cycle rickshaws, metro trains, and cars for traveling in cities and small towns. For traveling to further distances, many of us use railway trains and aeroplanes. People also use water transport like ships and boats. Unlike in the past, now people can travel to another country in a few hours. In the olden times, men traveled on foot. Later, they began to use animals such as horses and donkeys for traveling. It took a long time to travel this way. After the invention of wheel, people began to use carts and carriages for traveling. Gradually, modes of transport were developed with the changing lifestyles and work requirement of people. There are various means of transport available for traveling. These are land transport, water transport, and air transport. Well, students, what are land transport? All vehicles that move on roads are called land transport. For example, cars, buses, trucks, cycle rickshaws, auto rickshaws, and bicycles run on land. Another popular means of land transport are trains. Trains move on tracks that are laid on the ground. Earlier, trains used steam engines to run. A great amount of coal was burned in the engine to produce steam, which moved the train. Nowadays, trains use diesel or electric engines to run. These trains run faster than the earlier trains. The metro train in Delhi runs on an electric engine. The fact file says that maglev train in Japan is the fastest mode of land transport in the world. It runs on tracks made of magnets. Now, what is water transport? Vehicles that move on water are called water transport. For example, motorboats, ships, yachts, and rafts are used to travel on water to distant places. These vehicles carry goods and people over rivers, seas, and oceans. Before humans began to travel by air, water transport was the most common way of traveling to distant countries. Next is air transport. Today, aeroplanes are fastest means of transport on earth. They fly in the sky and transport goods and people from one city to another city as well as to another country. Now, traveling longer distances is possible in the shortest time. An airport is a place where aeroplanes land, take off, and are kept for maintenance and repair. It also has a runway. A runway is a long stretch on which an aeroplane moves before taking off or landing. Helicopters are other popular means of air transport. They have blades or rotors on top which spin fast and lift them off the ground. They can fly close to the ground as well as water and can even hover at a place. Helicopters are mostly used by armed forces in rescuing people during floods or at sea. The pictures given below shows past and present times. Stick the things you see today. Use buildings we see in present times. Second is coin. We cannot see. It is a past. And third is metro train. We see in present time. So students, that's all in this video. Hope you all enjoyed. I'll continue with the same chapter in the next video. Until then, thank you.